right, you little fucking smartasses out there that think anybody that hates America is patriotic, you know nothing about Iran, much less the fact that private universities require and use my and your tax money. Apparently, your parents pay your way since you have no grasp of financial reality or the history of Iran. So much for Ivy League intellectualism. Shah Pahlavi, the guy that was in charge before any of you little retards were born, was good friends with the United States, which means it's now time for little indoctrinated liberals to instinctively hate Shah. Tehran was known as the Paris of the Middle East. The country was gorgeous. Women were not bound to wear the chador. Women worked and owned businesses. Laws were determined by the government, and judges presided over courts. Was their government as free as ours is? Of course not, but it's a hell of a lot better than the Sharia law they have today. You know, Sharia law, one woman is equal to half a man. Oh, I'm sure you've done extensive research on the details of Sharia punishment in Iran today. Shah relieved the cultural burden of Sharia on Iran's minorities. Iranian children were educated throughout the world, and Shah's son Reza was trained to fly by our Air Force. He was the youngest person to fly an F-14, under the Golden Gate Bridge, no less. Iran was a free country. Women were wearing miniskirts. Thanks to the mullah-loving morons, it was not until France afforded Ayatollah Khomeini 1 hour airtime every day to broadcast his fundamental beliefs to Iranian students, including your pal Mahmoud. Khomeini indoctrinated those students to believe that Shah had corrupted the Iranian people by allowing women to go outside, heads uncovered. Forget about the miniskirts. Jimmy Carter was president and believed we should not support Shah anymore. Just when a free Iran needed the U.S. most to steel itself against Khomeini and the increasingly hostile uprising of the revolution. Oh, sounds cool, right? Yeah, not so much. Most of the Iranian youth in the U.S. you know today are descended from the waves of the businessmen, doctors, and real scholars who fled this brutal regime with their families, most leaving everything, including their homes and businesses. My friend Reza and his sister were fortunate to be in schools outside of the country when the revolution occurred. Their parents were trapped in Iran. Shah was deposed and diagnosed with terminal cancer. Carter refused to allow our U.S. ally to spend his last months with his family in the United States. Shah died in Panama. I know because I went to school with his daughters. I still write in Farsi. Reza, not Shah's son, my friend Reza, was put on the front line of the war upon his return to Iran. The regime took his family's home in Esfahan along with their business. Their grandfather, who had worked in Shah's administration, was executed by the same regime your Mahmoud presides over today. After 1982, I never heard from any of them again. If the current regime cared about open talks, you little free speech shitheads, they would not have destroyed diplomatic ties by taking our embassy and diplomatic staff hostage for 444 days. There is one thing more important than free speech to keep lines of dialogue flowing between countries, you little shits. It's called diplomatic immunity. And the current regime of Iran shut down diplomatic ties. Not us, you morons. God. Besides, if you cared about free speech, you wouldn't give it to a goddamn monkey. But you give that murderer free speech. Ours. In Iran yesterday, the headline was Mahmoud gets standing ovation. Surprisingly, no mention in their censored press of Bollinger ripping him a new one. The BBC has bundled audio clips of Columbia students, and it's not the students saying Bollinger really nailed him. Just clips of students who said they were disappointed in Columbia for being rude to the murderer. You can find it all online. In Iran, Mahmoud will soundbite his clips into the ones where everyone's applauding him, not Bollinger's comments. Since free speech does not exist in Iran, but censorship does, Iranians can't flip to a free CNN like you and me. They'll simply hear American students applauding the maniac that's oppressing them. Now, while you may hate America, we are still the country that the oppressed look to for help. And now, thanks to you guys, the majority of Iranians, now it looks like Columbia students applaud Mahmoud and his oppressive regime. Good job! Columbia provided priceless propaganda to further aid in oppressing innocent people. But what did we learn for this impossible cost? Mahmoud denies the Holocaust, knew that, denies homosexuals, knew that, supports Palestine over Israel, knew that, he lied a few times, knew that. Wow, what did you little retards learn from Mahmoud's insane rhetoric that he is now using against you that you could not have found in any free press? The press is supposed to be free too, you little fuckheads, remember? You can get information about evil bastards by reading up on news reports online. You don't have to invite them into your fucking living room. If you can't read, he is also available online speaking the same rhetoric on video. By giving this crazy person whose opening line was praying for the return of the Imam Mahdi, that's the guy who, according to Muslims, precedes the second coming of Jesus and triggers the redemption of Islam and defeat of its enemies. Jesus and the Mahdi then work together to unite the Muslims and true Christians under true Islam. This after Jesus returns and denies he's the Son of God. Look it up in the Quran, 43:61. Now you little godless fucks are really confused, aren't you? Who's Jesus? So when it comes to providing the free speech afforded us by our Constitution and the blood, sweat, tears, and lives of many generations of soldiers, we should value that right and not disperse it with abandon. Because you can do something doesn't mean you should. You could set yourselves on fire, but unfortunately, you don't. Besides, the Iranian people were counting on us not to applaud. I'm a dumb blonde, and I would have thought the geniuses at Columbia could have figured that out. Like I said before, if you don't stand for something, you'll fall for anything. Why don't you look up who said that?